The microsporogenesis. Microsporogenesis is pre-fertilization event. This is the formation of male gamete. Or simply say, we can say that the process of formation of microspore. Microspore, or we also call it pollen. We also call it pollen grain. The formation of gametes takes place with the help of meiosis. So pollen grains or microspores are the male gametes, and male gametes are formed. Male gametes or gametes are haploid, and haploid gametes are formed through meiosis. So microsporogenesis is the process of formation of microspores from pollen mother cell or microspore mother cell through meiosis. Understand? This is a pre-fertilization event. And now let us see, how does this process takes place? We can see that microsporogenesis takes place inside the anther. Now anther is, we already studied, anther is bilobed. We have already studied bilobed. If we cut this transversely, and we can find this structure. We can see the structure like this. This is the transverse section of anther. Then you can see that each lobe consists of two pollen sacs, and this pollen sacs is also known as theca. This pollen sacs is also known as theca, and that is why this anther is called dithecus. So anther is bilobed and dithecus anther. So if you see this structure, then you will find that pollen grains are formed here, and pollen grains comes out after dehiscence of pollen sacs contains pollen grain, and pollen grains are formed in four chambers, and these four chambers are called microsporangium. So each anther has four microsporangium, and microspores are formed in microsporangium. And if you see, so we will see the structures like this. You can find that there are four microsporangium, and in each microsporangium microspores are formed. When the anther is young, what happens in young anthers? A group of meristematic tissues, meristematic cells are there, and such cells are called archiosporial cells, and these cells further divides, and it gives two cells, that is the first cell which is formed is primitive parietal cells, and second one which we get a sporogenous cells, and this sporogenous cell further it divides, and it give microspore mother cell. This gives microspore mother cells, and this parietal cells forms four walls of anther. Isn't it? So what we have seen that in the young anther there are a collection of group of meristematic tissues, and this group of meristematic tissue further divides and give rise to two cells, two kinds of cells. And the first cell, that is my primitive parietal cells give rise to four walls of anther on maturation. And sporogenous cells further it divides, and after division it gives microspore mother cells. The anther, if you see the anther, consists of four walls. The first, the outermost wall, that is epidermis. Second is endothecium, and third one is middle layers, and fourth one is the innermost layer is tapetum. You can see if you enlarge this area, then you will get like this structure. In large form is this, and outermost is epidermis. The next one is endothecium, then middle layers, and last in innermost layer, that is tapetum. And epidermis is single layer of cells. Epidermis is single layer of cells, and this is protective in function. Endothecium is single layer second wall. The cells have cellulose thickening with a little pectin and lignin. It helps in anther dehiscence. When anther matures and dries, it ruptures, and this rupture of dried and matured anther is called dehiscence. Then next layer is middle layers. Middle layers, it may be the layers of 1 to 6 layers of cells. And middle layer degenerates at the time of maturity. It degenerates at the time of maturity of the anther. When the anther matures, this layer dehydrates and degenerates. The last layer, that is tapetum. Tapetum is the innermost layer of anther wall surrounding sporogenous tissue. Tapetum surrounds sporogenous tissue, and the sporogenous tissue further it divides, and it gives rise to microspore mother cells, or you can say pollen mother cells also. Tapetal cells, very important. These are nutritive in nature, and it has a nutrition, so it provides nutrition to the sporogenous tissue. And this may be binucleated, it may be multinucleated also. And here, when yeast bodies are deposited in the exine of microspores mother cells, yeast bodies are deposited in the exine of microspore wall. So there are four layers of anther: epidermis, endothecium, middle layer, and tapetum. And these structures are very important in the examination point of view. Now let us see, how does the microspore mother cell give microspore? Now the sporogenous tissues, after few divisions, give rise to microspore mother cell. And microspore mother cell undergo meiosis, and after meiosis, this microspore mother cell, which is diploid in nature, and this diploid microspore mother cell, or you can also call it pollen mother cell, because each microspore mother cell is diploid, and each microspore mother cell will undergo meiosis, and it will give rise microspore tetrad. That means it will give rise to four microspores, and all the four microspores will be connected with each other. So this is known as microspore tetrad. And after some time, what happened, the anther will mature. This anther here, what happened, anther mature, anther matures, then anther dries. Dries how? Dehydration will take place. Dehydration, it will dehydrate, and after dehydration it will dehiscence. Dehiscence of the anther will take place, and after all that anther matures. अंतर जो है मैच्योर होगा, ड्राई होने के बाद डिहाइड्रेट होगा, डिहाइड्रेट और उसके बाद ये रप्चर्स होंगे. रप्चर के बाद इट विल बी सेपरेटेड, ऑल दी फोर माइक्रोस्पोर विल बी सेपरेटेड एंड दे विल फॉर्म पॉलन ग्रेन. सो ईच पॉलन मदर सेल विल गिव फोर pollen grains or microspores, and each pollen grain will be haploid, isn't it? Will be haploid. So microsporogenesis is the process of formation of microspore from pollen mother cell through meiosis.